All right, team, this is Phantos, who is about to go against Ghost Train. Now, the first one we're going to be attacking, of course, is Armed. This team is monstrous. They are a top 100, probably mid-100s team. I don't know how they made it all the way back to 361, but, you know, this is not even within our category. But I want to show you again how I play, and let's see how well I do against a team this strong. Now, Armed is one of the two weakest islands, but I don't think that's going to make a difference, because even their weak is strong. So, I mean, some of these guys have 17 mythics, so, you know, I mean, we're not on the same level. So, like I say, win, lose, or draw, you're going to see what I do and if it works against a much stronger opponent. And as you can see, he already has a fully evolved Louise that was just released. So these guys spend a lot of money on their decks. And as you can also see, I got nothing at all here. Literally one of the worst possible hands I can start with against the strongest team. Okay, that's good. Maybe this is one of the weaker ones. No, he's not. I remember all their names. And wow. Okay. It's Leela. Again, I don't see a point. Let's put him up for the heal. Right now, this is not looking... Wow, another music. As you can see, that Christmas trap has 20 punch and 29, so... I mean, 29 attacks, so we're looking at I have to defend 50. The only card I got that might be able to make it, if she attacks him with everything. Okay, caught a break. Peter might actually be strong enough to beat her. Now we actually do have a shot. Don't know how big of a shot, but we got a shot. Because Pantry Guns plus Leela makes one of my strongest combos. Rest of Bobby, I wouldn't worry about that. I mean, look at what it does. Absolutely nothing. That's why I say only research the good combos, because that Wrestler Bobby, under normal circumstances, I wouldn't even care about it. I'm going to ignore. I'm going to take that 26 that 20 damage from wrestler Bobby to make this power play. Let's see what happens. She can take out the. Okay. She can take out. Power gem, what it does with her. Golf ring, that's a frenzy. And that's a rodeo. Rodeo Bobby. I don't. Well, let's see what's here. Doghouse. Or. I'm going to do something I don't normally do. Because I have a mastery. Okay. This one I would actually already put in the win column. Close one, but I think I'm going to get the win here. Okay, this is one of their weaker. This can't be one of their weaker ones. I don't remember that name. Didn't work out the way I planned, but if I have to, let's see. Just gonna put in Power Gem then. And that's a win. That was a close one. Okay, first round goes to me. I can already see what's going on. First mythic of the day. Does Meg go with any of these well? That's not an ideal combo, nor is that. That's definitely not an ideal combo. Got 26. I'm gonna go crazy. The reason I'm choosing this one is that drain with the this drain with that backlash is really strong, and it might be able to take out that mythic. If the mythic attacks me. Okay, well, Hunter Amy, that's a tough one. In fact, I forgot that first one doesn't attack. we're going to go Bobby can take out the first one. Well, he didn't. Okay, now it gets a little rougher. I think he's going to take out one of my people. Which one? I don't know. No, I know. Dale. Can at least maybe survive. Got 26 gas. This game, I'll just play it out, but there's really nothing I can do. 1-1. And that one caused me because I forgot that that first one that they give you can't attack. Okay, let's see who's coming in here. Well, so far it looks like Newsville and me. And there's somebody else because I've lost one and only won one. So there's somebody else on our team. But other teams coming up pretty strong, which isn't a big surprise. I mean, they are a strong team. Here. Okay, we do have a very strong combo. I'm just checking. We have two strong combos. No, three. Lois. Okay. Well, who can survive a bad hit here? Lois can herself. Ooh. Okay. Choices. This beast. Or. Let's see. I'm still iffy between these two. I'm going to go with this one because of the pump. And plus, that mask doesn't create a lot of super strong combos in the deck. So, that's the most powerful one with that card. The others can go with somebody else. Alright, I chose right. Next. Gonna be rough. But with luck, we can knock out one of the first two. Hopefully we get rid of one or both of those mythics right now. Okay, that's a good sign. Boy crazy, not really a, not something I worry about. Alrighty then. Do I want to power up Leela or go for my next combo? We'll power up Leela to ensure somebody, I can get somebody out there who can block Roger. Because if I don't do that, Roger is going to have two free shots. And if he fuses, it's over. Okay. Badminton Roger or Max. I'm going to put Roger up. Normal circumstances, that's not a good idea. Hopefully you have a better machine than I do. Because you could see the what all the combo stats were. I couldn't see them right then. Okay, second mythic down. Roger's weekend. Next card tells the tale. And that is a great combo for me. Unfortunately, I know S&M Peter is kind of one you end up getting without trying. So do we do... So that's a 14. We do Batman Roger with a 14, 21. Or a 27, 19 with Frenzy. Max Jets is about to take him out. Or not. Okay. Strong enemy. Two down. Now this is interesting. I guess they know that they can beat us, so they're not even, they're not, oh, it looks like they're aiming at Art, but they got a lot of random hits. Maybe, hopefully that will make it so that we have an advantage. So we're going straight four. Armed again. Okay. All right, one of the strongest combos in the game is about to come up. Now, this is going to be interesting. Wow. Okay, that Lois is pretty strong. Louise, sorry. Now, I'm more scared of Whale Hunter Amy's bomb. But we're going with this weapon one because it's going to get a boost up to 60, I think. Yeah, 60 life. So it can handle it. Ooh. 104 life. The only thing we can do here is hope that, hold on, maybe Leela isn't the best choice right now. Leela is definitely not the best choice. I'm pretty sure for 2166. 2560, Tina. Now it's gonna be a big difference who she attacks this round, what happens next. Wow. If Christmas Trap attacks Balloon Fight, I think we just won. Okay. Tomatoes and Roger. I'm just going to put Leela out straight. Because what's going to happen is Wingnut Amy is just going to attack Tina, take it out. Oh, I did not even notice that. It doesn't matter. It's over. There's really no reason to add this on there, so we'll just play a random card. The fight's done. Okay. Forgot this whole time to turn the sound down, so guys, sorry. Have any of them lost against us? Well, one of them has lost Bucky. The rest of them are doing pretty well. Let's see how my team is doing real quick. At 85. Yeah. Kind of what I expected. I mean, Luke is coming in strong. He's already used all of his. Attacks. And to be honest, Luke, you just did great. Okay. All right, we're gonna start this combo with music. Because he goes the best. Because we'll start with K-pop Peter. Again, I get very happy when I see a bad combo. I mean, actually a lot about this is bad. You have Bender, who only heals Futurama. And then you got, oh, okay, this must be one of their weak ones. Which is good. I got lucky. We're going with, let me be sure. Yeah, Wrestler Amy, not worth it. So I'm probably gonna go with that Roger combo. Nope, Nurse Tina. Forgot about that one. Always gotta check. Now, if that happens, this is already over. Since first card's down, and second, two epics. Okay, this was one of the weaker ones. And this pretty much ends it. And I've got my next card set up with Iraq Lobster and Roger to make a marmalade, which will seal the deal. They will not, you know, there's nothing they can do. Now, this is strange. Why on earth is this character in such a strong guild? It must be an alt that's being leveled or something. Okay, you have a fully evolved Peter, but you're running green cards? This is an example of somebody who doesn't know what they're doing. They probably have the cards, but they don't have any real knowledge. I mean, you would have kept that Peter separated into four different characters so you wouldn't have to have any green cards in the deck, or you would have had two dual fuse mythics over those epics. Okay, that was actually easy. That was easier than anything I thought I would get in this game. And my poor team is I mean, if I played 5, so it's not updated. Play 5, lost 1, so moving up in the leaderboard. Now, the only reason I like to be on top is because I think it does lend a little extra weight to what I tell people, so it doesn't seem like I don't know what I'm talking about. It's kind of hard, for me at least, to listen to somebody who isn't showing that they know anything themselves. Yeah, I just tried to see what the merger between Peter and Dale was. That's my, okay, now Dale merges good with Blurn's Ball, but I think Peter is stronger. I mean, and also something else you guys might want to look at, for the most part, the fully fused legendaries are just as strong, or in some cases stronger than the mythic. I mean, you can look at the difference. There's basically 1 point of difference between Peter and Dale, so it's not 17, 18. So it's not. So you don't necessarily need the epics. I mean, the mythics. 17. Mountain Climber Peter. Is that strong enough for this level of play? I'm gonna go with Dale. And this is a tough one. Lord knows this one's hard. All right. So again, let's look at this card for a second, guys. Okay, it only targets all of its abilities target athletic. Which might mean that in his case, he has a bunch of course, athletic cards if he's a higher level. But let's see here. Strange he didn't put himself in athletic. But of course, he has a 19 attack. My attack is 34. So that combo isn't going to help him because now he has an educated card. So none of the effects that come from that baseball Bobby are going to affect anything he has. Go ahead with the pantry gum because it actually combos with Peter and a good number, and it makes some strong combos with most of the other cards left in my deck. Or at least Lois, Leela, my other core. And I believe Bobby as well. So now I'm going against two mythics with one of mine. Difference is I've got punch, they don't. Now this is where RP Jesus comes into play. Who? Oh, four mythics. First one's gone. Question is, can I take out the rest? Well, first one might be gone. Second one's definitely gone. And Power Gem Roger. We're going to go for it. Not the strongest combo in the world, but useful. Second mythic is down. Without question. First and second mythics down. This is starting to add up to me getting a win here. Okay. Okay, so before anything else is calculated, damage done to their cards is going to be about 52. So it's a possibility. Okay. So now I think I can safely call it in my favor here. Me against three mythics. Basically because whoever she attacks wasn't gonna die. And here, we're gonna go ahead and guarantee with Cognac Bender that Leela goes right here, right now. I think both of these cards are gone. Yeah. Three mythics up, three mythics down. And now that Tina has to survive. You know, that battery of punches is coming for regardless, but of course, either way, Peter's gonna kill her, kill the enemy. So once again, stronger opponent, better cards, but you're not playing another player, you're playing the AI. And all you gotta do is outskill an AI. Okay, four more to go, guys. Not too bad overall. I mean, we've taken down 15 of them. I mean, how many people have attacked, though? Wow. I mean, there's an attack. Who knows? Maybe it'll come down to participation. Maybe we can kill one and they're all over this place. Alright. So how many am I gonna win out of 10? Right now we are 5-1. Shrimp dress. Don't know what that turns into. There's nothing good here. Wrong. Cupid Bobby. That's a good combo only in. It's a good combo against what I have up. So this is going to be. Okay. Maybe this is an easy win. When I see a unevolved epic. Okay, we've already had this discussion. Blurn's Ball. He's going to give him a little tap. Get some attack in so he can use his drain. Next card will tell me what to do. That another epic? Okay. Yeah. That might have been a mistake because that's going to take away that positive from Bobby. But Okay. Love the AI tech in the wrong card. Game over, peeps. He took out a punch. I mean, he took out one of them. Peter took out, oh, same person I fought earlier. Really bad deck building skills. Really bad. And this one will seal the deal, and I'll put up a heal next to. Wow. Maybe I won't put up that heal. Pantry guns always changes things. See who can survive this barrage. Okay, and she'll take out nobody. Okay, my next move is going to be I'm going to ignore. Wow, he spent a lot of money on that. Lord, whatever one Lord Griffith was in. Either way, he's not going to take out. Yeah, I don't think he's going to take out Wingnut Amy easily. Once Dale comes into this, it's gonna be over. As I can see it now, nobody's dying anytime soon on either side. I will give it. This is going a lot longer than it should have. But I see at least one card of hit theirs going down next round, maybe more. Dale plus pantry guns. Let's see who survives. So evil stepsister is definitely going down as it should. It shouldn't have been on there that long anyway. So Doing is going down. He can take out. All right, so he's gutted. Now in this case, no, I'm not that worried. Motivate ain't gonna do nothing. That frenzy. What I'm gonna do is just throw bodies in front of it. What's the attack? And that's the one thing I don't like is okay, 43. So let me over there. What? Bender can take one attack. I'm gonna do this and never mind. Bender isn't gonna get attacked, is he? So the question is that cute witch of the north that's stuck around forever gonna be around at the end of it? Okay, twice against a fairly easy enemy. So that's six. All right, guys, three more to go. That one was tough. I don't see them as being that disorganized. My guess is our best chance on this is that they think we were nothing, so they didn't plan. What I have here is two frenzy combos. That's what I'm going to use. And he has a stronger one. That's going to be damn near unbeatable. When you have frenzy with should have chose the other one. That's my best chance of a victory. Yeah, frenzy with leech. It gets rough fast. And that fast, Snake Hunter. We're gonna do this to get a little extra oomph and hope beyond hope. I don't remember what his base is as far as health. Okay, he might actually beat. We could care less about Christian Rock. Okay, the fact that he's still there. Assassin Bender is gone. Oops. Forgot to plug it in. Okay. Before I do anything, okay. So the question is, I don't think any of these go well with him. But we're just going to do that because that's basically the best choice we got. I could just play another card and try to get a good combo with Dale, but even though I'm not intimidated by the Christian Rock, bye-bye Assassin Bender, by the way. The crown's still there. I was gonna say, even though I'm not intimidated by Christian Rock, I don't want to just leave that card just sitting there. And think I'm gonna go ahead, and I got the best card for my addicted Leon Petard. Like I say, to be honest, Dale is not. Oops. Sorry about that, guys. Dale is not my best card. It's a mythic, but overall, not impressive. As you can see, other cards are putting out a lot more work than him. Two to go. And that's really interesting how they're doing it. Both Drunk and Art are almost down to the same point. In theory, they can actually take out all three of the islands they've attacked, but should they have a low turnout, that could hurt them a lot. If we get this win, it would be, I mean, the word epic doesn't even describe how powerful that would be. High Leg Man, which is a fairly weak combo. I have a better one, of course, with Cock Gun and Meg. Oh no, I'm wrong. High Leg Man, it is. There was a card I should have put in my deck that I didn't. I completely forgot. Three times against. Okay. I'm sorry. This is not what I wanted to show. I was not expecting to go against a weak opponent three times. I mean, okay, he has a fully evolved Tina and he's running a Stan. I wouldn't even say he's weak. I will say he doesn't know what he's doing. Okay. Well, that Tina's gone anyway. It would have been better for him to have two Tinas than a t than a four a quad fuse Tina and a Stan. This isn't a bad combo. It's a Fury one, though. I guess what now the strategy has basically become keep that third spot open and let that Fury get out of control, so that the AI has to figure out a way to deal with it. How this character made it into that guild, I do not know. Okay, strongest Peter. I think. Let's see here. So it took. Okay. Board wipe, game over. Nothing can happen now. This person is literally running quad fused legendaries while he still has epics. I said, I'm kind of apologize that the match is putting me against the weakest, one of the strongest in our guild. They put me against the weakest in there. Whoa, we're actually making a come up here. This is going to be hella interesting. You guys will definitely hear about this in the chat. With them spread out like that, something's wrong. I don't know if maybe their leadership has gone to crap, but this shouldn't look like this. Okay, and one. Okay, Balls Deep. He's the one that had. I think he had two or three mythics. This almost looks like the same. Okay, playlist Meg. Wow, I always wanted the Haley card. Yeah, I am not intimidated by that whatsoever. Let's see what we got here. High Leg Man. Nasal Spray Peter, not really a big deal. His wall isn't big enough to handle that, or a Cannon Peter. We'll go for the High Leg Man. And the strongest of the two cards is Roger. Now, this can really get ugly quick, because if he fuses that cat with gun, Roger's gone. He doesn't fuse. Roger's gonna have one life left. All right. Let's look at 23 there. 21 there. So we know what's the next. We know what the next move. Oh wait a minute. Didn't Roger? Yeah, but I'm not gonna. I wasn't gonna give Roger to that. Wait on Roger. Put our pantry down to go with Roger there. Okay, but Roger is gone now. All right. Weapon versus weapon. Excuse me. Okay. So Dale, or we're actually gonna go with Penguin Conspirator because it's a stronger card, and then Dale can well, actually either Dale or Peter can go with Blurring's Ball. But either way, this pretty much, depending on how these attacks go, if they don't, okay, that's good. Okay, if they don't attack who's in front of them, or they do, game over. 9 out of 10. Okay, but as you can see, it's not about the cards, it's about the skill and being able to read the AI. Alright guys, that's how I did. Good luck out there. This is a tough one, but contrary to what I believed before, if things keep going the way they are going, we might actually have a chance of winning this if we can reduce armed down. And they keep out being all scattershot, we might actually pull this out. All right, I am surprised. Good luck, guys, and fight your hearts out. We might actually pull this off. Before I go, let's see what we got here. Yeah, I mean they are it's definitely gonna take a lot to beat these guys, but like I say, it's a possibility. I'm seeing, not all of our people have come up yet, and we may at least take that island out. And if they don't have the turnout, that might be one island might be enough. All right, good luck, guys.